Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. I'm going to show you how to add any text you want to an iMovie project and have it pop into place with some animation. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon where you can read more, join us, and get exclusive content. So the titles available in iMovie are quick and easy to use, but they don't always get you the effect you want. Sometimes you want specific text in a specific location and you want it to animate onto the screen. Sometimes this is called pop-up text, where it just moves in from off of the frame and then moves back out again. You can use any image editing app you want to create text and put it as an overlay in iMovie. I'm going to show you how to do it in Keynote, but you could use Photoshop, Acorn, Pixelmator, Affinity, anything you want to create the transparent text backgrounds, and then I'll show you how to bring it into iMovie and animate it.
Alright, so let's start off in Keynote. Now we want to choose a wide theme because that's going to be 16:9, the same ratio as most video. I'm going to start with just the standard black template here. I'm going to get rid of this sample text here and add my own text to it. So I'm going to use a text box. It'll be here in the middle. I'll type some text. Then I'm going to make it much larger. Matter of fact, I'm not going to be afraid to fill the space with it. Even if I don't want the text to actually be this big in the video, I want it to take up as much of this screen as possible. Now, I could set it to be any kind of font that I want, so I can make it something kind of fancy, and I could change its color, and I can even add outlines, do all sorts of things that I normally couldn't do with text. So after I've got it looking like I want, I need to do a very important step here. I need to click on the background, so just outside of any element, and under Format, I need to change the background for the slide layout, for the document itself, to no fill. This is an important step. If you don't do this, you're just going to get a big black rectangle with some text in it. I just want the text by itself. So now I've made the background invisible. One of the cool things I can do is if I have multiple pieces of text I want to include in the video, I can do them all in one Keynote document. So I'm going to control click here and duplicate this slide here, and I'm going to put some other text here as an example. And I can have 50 different pieces of text here. Now I'm going to go to File, Export To, and I'm going to export as images. Now here I have to choose the format PNG. JPEG format will not give me transparency, and I want to make sure the checkbox for export with transparent backgrounds is selected. Then I'll go next, and I'll save this out to the desktop. I'll call it movie text and export it. And it's going to export each one of these slides as a different image. If I hide Keynote here, I could see there is the folder, and here I've got two PNGs, and you could see they're transparent because there's no black background there. So I've got the two pieces of text there. Now let's go into iMovie. And in iMovie here, I've got a project going already. Instead of using titles, I'm going to simply bring these images in as overlays. So I'm going to move over the window here a bit, and I'm going to drag and drop this PNG on top of the video. I'm not going to put it into the main timeline like this. I'm going to actually stick it on top of it so it's an overlay. Now I can position it where I want, and I could stretch the beginning and end. And you can already see that this text appears over the background. It's transparent. So now I want to change a few things about this. First, I want to click on the video overlay settings here, make sure that's selected, and switch to picture in picture. Then I want to change the transition to 0 seconds, so it doesn't actually dissolve or zoom or anything over any period of time. It just appears. Then I want to click here in the cropping settings. It might be set to Ken Burns by default. I'm going to change it to Fit. So in other words, turn off all the cropping settings. Then I'm going to go back over here to the overlay settings. So I've got this piece of text. I want to position it where I want and stretch it by pulling the corners to be the size I want. So let's say this is where I want it to be when it fully appears. Now all I have to do is have it transition in so it slides in from the right. Notice this little interface here, these two arrows with this little plus button inside of a diamond here. That's for adding keyframes. This is what we're going to use to animate. It's a really powerful feature in iMovie that a lot of people don't know is there. And it only works if you've got a picture-in-picture overlay. So I'm going to position the cursor somewhere near the beginning of the clip here. If you don't see this little interface here and you don't see these blue dots around the picture-in-picture, double click on the clip here to actually make sure you activate it. Now I'm going to find its starting position and I'm going to put it just off to the right side of the screen. You see I still can see the box even though I can't see the text. I'm going to hit the plus button to add a keyframe. Now I'm going to move the line so it's right about here. And I'm going to add another keyframe and then change the position to be where I want it to be. So now when I scrub over this I can see it starts off to the right and then it moves into place and stops. I'm going to go towards the end here, double click to set the position there, and then I'm going to click in here, add a little keyframe there. Don't do anything with the position there. I want it to move to another area and add another keyframe there. So I'll click in there, add another keyframe, and move it back out. So now at the end here I've got it moving out. So there are four keyframes in this. The first one is just on the right side. The next one has it in position and so does the third one. And the fourth one has it off of the screen. I can use these arrows to go between all of these. So I can see there's the first one, second one, third one, fourth one. So four keyframes. Play around with this and practice this so you can get this right, because you can have it appear anywhere. You can have it come off from the left side of the screen onto the right side of the screen, up and down. You can resize so you can actually have it be a smaller size at one of the keyframes and then go to a larger size on another keyframe. So let's do another one. I'm going to select this and remove it. I'm going to move in the second piece of text here and then I'm going to change it so it's cropped to fit. I'm going to change it so it's picture in picture, and I'm going to take away any transition. Now I'm going to have it start in the upper left hand corner. I'm going to go and set the keyframe there, add a keyframe, and I'm going to shrink it so it's really tiny and even off screen there. Then I'm going to move the line over and then I'm going to add another keyframe. This one is going to be the bottom right hand corner and it's going to be pretty large like that. Then I'm going to move again towards the end and create a new keyframe. Notice sometimes I have to select the picture in picture in order for the keyframe controls to appear. So I'm going to keep that as the same, but I'm going to go to the end here, add another keyframe, and then this one is going to shrink off to this side right over there. So now my complete animation looks like this. So you can do so much with this, but first you really have to master using that keyframe animation with overlays in iMovie. So practice with that. Then you can use it with text, you can use it with graphics, you can do all sorts of cool special effects that you probably didn't think were possible in iMovie before. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.